Page 16. Exercise 5. Solving Mysteries. Part B. Listen again. What ideas did Sheila and Adam originally have? Answer the questions.
Hey, Adam. Where did you call me from earlier? It was so noisy.
A gas station. I called while I was filling up my tank.
Oh, no. You shouldn't have called me from there. I heard it's dangerous to use a cell phone at a gas station.
Really?
Yes. Cell phones produce microwave radiation. You know, the beam of energy that sends the message. I believe it can ignite gasoline.
Oh, so that's what you're worried about. Well, you don't have to worry anymore. It's not really true, Sheila. They investigated that question on an episode of Solving Mysteries, that TV show that exposes the truth about everyday myths and mysteries.
Solving Mysteries? I love that show.
Yeah, it's great. Well, as I was saying, on this one episode, they experimented with cell phones and gasoline, and they found that it's not actually possible to cause a gasoline explosion with a cell phone. The real danger is an electrical spark caused by static electricity. You know, the kind of spark you get when you touch a doorknob after walking across a carpet. But that has nothing to do with cell phones.
Oh, I guess I must have missed that episode. But I loved the one around the question of whether talking to plants really helps them grow. Did you see it?
No, I don't think so. But I wouldn't think that talking to plants helps with their growth. I mean, plants can't understand what we say to them, right?
Well, that's true. But a scientific study showed that plant growth actually speeds up if you expose the plants to certain sounds for a long time. So talking to plants for a long time might actually help them. But of course, the amount of time any normal person would have to talk to plants doesn't help them.
Interesting. But I still don't think I'll start talking to my plants.
That's okay. I don't do it, and my plants are all doing fine.
Do you remember when Solving Mysteries investigated whether a singer can break a glass using just his or her voice?
I didn't see that one, but it sounds too incredible to believe. Our voices just don't have that kind of power.
Well, it's true that most of us can't do it, but a few people really can break crystal glasses using just their voices. They have to sing just the right note. I saw a rock singer do it. First, he tapped the side of the glass. He listened to the ringing sound the glass made, and then sang that same note very, very loudly. It only took a few seconds before the glass shattered.
Wow. I wish I'd seen that one. The last episode of Solving Mysteries I saw was kind of boring. It was exploring whether yawning is contagious.
You mean if other people around me yawn, will I start yawning?
Exactly.
Well, when I yawn, I express my own tiredness or boredom. If other people aren't tired or bored, they won't yawn just because I do.
Well, actually, scientists believe that people yawn when someone else does as a way of expressing their connection with that person.
I don't know about that.
No, really. Researchers have even found contagious yawning among chimpanzees, but mostly among chimpanzees that are part of the same group, and therefore have a bond or connection with each other.
I suppose that could be true. Maybe I should have yawned when you yawned a few minutes ago. I guess that would have made us better friends.
That's okay, Adam. You can communicate with me using language. We're not chimpanzees after all.